me take you far away and long ago to Hong Kong, just outside Kowloon of present day, for I would share the legend of sad Li-Mingxiu and the moon. She ought to have been grateful to be chosen, picked as the newest wife for Lord Zaying, picked for a single purpose, to give birth to a son. His other wives had failed him. Each had given birth to daughters, but he wanted, no, he required a son to one day fill his rank as the inheritor of all his lands. Li-Mingxiu knew she had been picked for this and not for love. The day she came into his house, he said,
"Your food and bed will be provided for, so long as you give me what I desire most, a son. But if you fail me, you'll have failed your parents, to whom I've paid a handsome sum to buy your hand. As you will suffer if you fail, so they will suffer. Whips will sting their backs, and you will watch their pain. So bear me sons, the more the better, and enjoy a seat of honor in my house."
Li-Mingxiu wept outside the walls of Lord Zaying's house. She wept with homesickness and fear. She wept all day and into night until the stars came out, and then the moon. The moon, kinder and more compassionate than the stars, hummed a song too soft for haughty lords to hear. The crickets and cicadas joined him humming, a wordless song to warm Li-Mingxiu's heart. His silver light reached past the clouds to brush her night-black hair and earth-brown skin. She leaned into the tender strokes of light.
"Thank you, sweet moon,"
she whispered, brave enough at last to go into the house and face what lay ahead. The days crawled on the backs of days and traipsed to months, and still Li-Mingxiu had no son. Even servants in the house belittled her.
"You think we make your bed and serve your food for nothing?
Worthless girl, you make our lives unbearable because our master rages at your emptiness.
He beats us hard, but soon he may beat you."
They spat in her food, filled her bed with sand, and sneered when she passed. Still no son would come to her. Again, Li-Mingxiu left the house and slumped against the outer walls to weep. She wept and thought of home, how she was loved by parents, friends, but now she was despised. She cried out to the moon, who cupped his hand of silver light and caught her tears. He hummed again the song to warm Li-Mingxiu's heart. Again the crickets and cicadas hummed along, and hope welled up in her again, enough to go into the house and face what lay ahead. The days crawled on the backs of days, and months became a year. Then late one night, the Lord Zaying burst through the door of his great house. He hollered like a lion, demanding everyone, the servants and Li-Mingxiu, to wake up and come. They did. And there Li-Mingxiu's parents stood bound up in rope with meaty guards holding them.
"Since, my wife, you disobey me and refuse to give me what I crave, you must be punished."
Lord Zaying clapped his hands. Li-Mingxiu watched in horror as the guards shoved both her parents to their knees, pressed their faces to the ground and ripped their garments to expose their backs. Another guard unwound a whip.
"Please, no!"
Li-Mingxiu cried.
"Lord Zaying, they are blameless! It's I who's earned the whip!"
"At last, my dear, you have admitted you are guilty. Thus, I do not punish them, but you. Your punishment, as I decree it, is to watch your parents tortured, as I have been this year without a son."
She watched her father's back torn up by whips, and then her mother's back. She tried to stop the guard, but felt a servant's arms holding her back to save her worst torments. Lord Zaying rubbed his dark-skinned hands and laughed. The beating's done. Lord Zaying sent her parents home and Li-Mingxiu back to bed. Instead, Li-Mingxiu crawled out of the window, down a tree, and slumped against the outer walls to weep.
"Sweet moon, no song of yours can soothe my heart tonight. I've lost all hope."
She wept and wept until the moon could take no more. He spoke, a voice like breezes through the dried leaves of the banyan tree. He said,
"Li-Mingxiu, hush. I have heard you. I can hardly bear another sob before my heart will break. Now hear me. I will give you what you seek, a son, indeed a host of sons, but you must give your last to me, for I am lonely here in the black sky, and crave a son."
"Oh, yes, sweet moon. If you will give me sons, I promise you will have the last."
She climbed the tree and slipped into her room that night, cheered by the promise of the moon. The servants could hardly understand her cheerfulness next day and days. The Lord Zaying as well was dumbfounded. One servant even said,
"Perhaps she's mad. Perhaps her mind has cracked the way a branch will crack if forced to bear too much weight."
Soon, however, all the house stirred with the news. Li-Mingxiu was to bear a child. None knew if it would be a son, but no one seemed to care, for there was peace again in the house. Servants cooked the rice with extra sugar, made her bed with silk sheets, and they bowed to her when she passed by. Lord Zaying, too, would sing about the house, his voice not good, but loud and jovial. Each night, Li-Mingxiu pressed her head out of the window, waving to the moon who had brought hope when hope was lost. One night, the time came for Li-Mingxiu to give birth. She cried with pain. Lord Zaying paced the foyer halls, shouting,
"Oh, let it be a son! Oh, let it be a son!"
The servants, too, felt fear and joy too intertwined to know the one from the other. At last, at midnight, at the climax of the moon, the child was born. A shout rang out throughout the house.
"A boy! A boy!"
Lord Zaying raced into the room to see his son, but stopped. The room at once fell silent, waiting for Lord Zaying to respond. He stared in horror at the child. The servants stopped their breathing. There, the child, perfect in every way but one, lay at Li-Mingxiu's breast. But everyone could see what the Lord Zaying saw, a child with skin as white as milk, as white as the moonlight.
"This is not my son. Look at my skin. It's dark, like the earth, dark like you, Li-Mingxiu. This is not my son. Li-Mingxiu, you have been unfaithful."
"No, The sun is yours, and you will soon have more.
The Lord pulled out a knife.
If you can't be trusted, you must die. You and your moon-white child.
Li-Mingxiu gripped her son and dashed from the room, dashed into the night, screaming and pleading help. But she could not outrun the Lord. He seized her gown and plunged his knife into her back. She fell dead to the ground. The child rolled from her arms onto the ground, and as he did, began to cry. Lord Zaying trembled at his deed. Li-Mingxiu's blood all over his hands, knife, and robe. Leaving the child to cry, he ran into the house and sobbed,
"What have I done? The blood, my blood!"
The baby cried. He cried and cried. He wriggled tiny fingers and he cried. And so the moon, who heard the cries, bent down and picked the baby up and pressed him to his chest. The little baby stopped his crying and cooed. And to this day, the moon is not alone. Whenever he, Li-Mingxiu's baby, is content, the moon shines full and bright and deep. But when the child begins to cry, the moon becomes a cradle so the child may sleep.